for these players, most of them walking up the tunnel for the very first time here and waiting for that wall of noise which is going to greet them. Listen to this. And Alan Buckley leading their teams out. We've heard from Mel as a player. He conceded the penalty that cost Norwich a League Cup final. That'll be pushed to the back of his mind this afternoon. What a moment for them. And Alan Buckley, who returned to Grimsby after an unhappy time at West Brom, full justification that he was right to go back.
Well, yes, he obviously had a very successful period before he went to West Brom with Grimsby, taking from the fourth through to the second division. And I think he feels it's really his home, as it were, in football terms. And he's gone back there and he's rebuilt the team the way he wants it. And he's been rewarded with the fruits of Wembley. And I mean, I've got goosebumps running down my spine sitting watching the lads because I'm so close to them all. And, you know, what I wouldn't give to be out walking on that pitch. But I'm just pleased that the lads will get the chance to sample it, as Matt says. You possibly only get to do this, if you're playing in the second division, once, maybe twice in your career. So for the lads to be down there, seeing their families now, just beside the Royal Box, it must be fantastic.
And Matt, you're itching to get out there as well, because you've never played here.
I've never played here, and I'm really looking forward to the game now. Like I say, I'm a touch of envy out there, but hopefully, like I say, maybe in a month's time, I might be out there as well.
Let's hope so. Who's going to be the key players for Grimsby this afternoon, Tommy?
Well, I think we've been based on a very good defence this season. I think we've kept about 30 clean sheets, which is in fact a club record, but we have played more than any other team in the whole of the four divisions. So our goalkeeper's a very, very steady lad in Aidan Davison, if he's called upon, of course. But I think outstanding for us this season has been our right-sided midfield player, Kevin Donovan. He's copped in with about 18 goals this season, albeit with six or so penalties, but he's very, very lively, he's very, very quick, he can take people on and he scores goals very well.
Well, the guest of honour this afternoon is the Northern Ireland manager, Laurie McManamy, who's about to be introduced to the teams, the Bournemouth team first. Briefly, Matt, who's the star man going to be for Bournemouth this afternoon?
I think there'll be a few. I mean, Steve Fletcher's done very well this season, and I think he's got a record total for himself of goals. His combination with Mark Steen will be important, the big man and the small man. Steve Robinson pushes forward from midfield, and he'll score goals. And there's a good combination on the right-hand side, Neil Young and John Bailey.
And as you've said, both teams do like to play football, so although Grimsby have a mean defence and Bournemouth have struggled a little bit recently, there should be a terrific game of football, shouldn't there?
Well, I think that's great that two sides who love to play football, get it on the floor and pass the ball, are here in the final today. I just hope it's a great game and we get a few goals.
Substitutes. Somebody is going to make themselves a hero this afternoon. And those two go back a long way together. But Menemy himself, a winner as a manager with Southampton, way back now in 1976 against Manchester United. Mel Machin must have thought when he left Manchester City that his day in the sun at Wembley had come and gone. Football is a funny old game, as somebody once said.
It's fantastic, really. I'm so pleased that the Bournemouth lads are out there enjoying the occasion. It's a fairy tale, isn't it?
They've done a good business in selling flags over the past few days. No Harry the Haddocks here this year. That was the big thing in Grimsby a few years back, wasn't it, Tommy?
Well, I remember the story of the legend of Harry the Haddock was a 1988 cup run. And he was brought back out of retirement last season when we were expected to do quite well. And we were convincingly trounced at Sheffield Wednesday 7-1, so I don't think they bothered with old Harry this time.
Let's have a listen to what Laurie McManamy is saying to some of the Grimsby players.
John McDermott. Tony Gilmore.
Paul Groves, the captain, introducing the players to Laurie.
David Smith. Lee Nogan.
Some of the key players, but Paul Groves could be the key man, having scored in both the league games. Very confident fellow. Wayne Burnett just being introduced to McManamy as a player that a lot has been said about in recent times.
Yeah, well, in fact, after I was injured, he was brought in on loan to replace me, and he's done ever so well. And after the initial loan period, Alan bought him for, I think, about £100,000, which has seemed to be another shrewd investment by the manager, because he's been a very much a success with the side.
Well, he's got plenty to say to everybody, as is usually the case, of course. Seems to have settled very well into international management, and he loves being a guest of honour. And Alan Buckley is obviously having the time of his life as well. That's a laugh. That's a smile.
Oh, yeah. Cheers, thank you.
But he's a very likeable man, Alan Buckley. It's great to see him here this afternoon. He was very disappointed when things didn't go his way at West Brom. A few people said he was not wise to go back to Grimsby, but he did. And he's doing the business for them. Let's now pause for the national anthems. Atmosphere inside Wembley. Kickoff fast approaching. It's time for us to join our commentators Alan Brazil and Rob Hawthorne.
Bournemouth have been the form team coming into the final. They've won three of their six matches since reaching Wembley, including the last two against York and Walsall. While for Grimsby, for whom this is the 62nd game of the season, they've won just one of their last eight since reaching the final. Clearly the minds of Alan Buckley's side have been distracted by the prospect of this visit. Away goes Donovan. And he's done well to skip past Vincent. He was looking for Clare. Nogan with a chance!
And Donovan immediately impact in the game. It just falls out, takes a good touch, gets on the left foot. And that's just slightly wide, but Glass had it covered.
Oh. Here's Clare!
And again, Glass had it covered. I think it was going wide, Rob. It's always good in striker, you know, especially here, big occasion. Try to get a strike away. Only one thing in his mind here. On the right foot, just sweeping wide, but again, Glass looked comfortable.
He's 19 years of age, Darrell Clare. Half an hour gone in the 1998 Auto Windscreen Shields final. First visit to Wembley for Grimsby and Bournemouth. No score, still evenly balanced. Fletcher and Steen looking to get in again. The goalkeeper come a long way and Bailey stolen in. John Bailey, one-time non-league player, came into the professional game late at 26 and makes a dream first appearance at the big stadium with a goal.
Yeah, just what the game needed. And Bailey took his chance well. Vincent delivers again. The big fella wins at Fletcher. Goalkeeper stranded here. Bailey nips in. Thank you very much, get in there. Mel Machen's men draw first blood. Good touch again from Fletcher. Goalkeeper, I just feel, comes a long way, Davison. And now he's grounded, lost, and Bailey tucks in the empty net. I think Fletcher plays a big part here. Once again, good leap. Steen on the end of it, handy size is close, gets his head to it. Bailey gets a little touch. Can't believe his luck. Thank you, 1-0.
Well, the first Wembley final for this competition saw the introduction of a family enclosure at Wembley, and that's why the Auto Windscreen Shield final, as it now is, has become known as the family final. But that first one here actually attracted the lowest attendance of them all, and that was in excess of 30,000. Could well be almost double that here today.
Busy time coming up for Wembley.
playoff finals looming. I think it's a great idea.
Oh, tremendous effort. And John McDermott there pulling the save from Glass out of the fire.
Yeah, I think Glass was thinking about trying to catch this, and at the last minute just pushes it wide. A lot of power and pace on it, good angles from the keeper.
No good. John McDermott, Grimsby with four in the box. Good play with Donovan. McDermott gets it across. Black is there! And it's gone in! Young on the line, couldn't keep it out. And Kingsley Black, the substitute, has rescued Grimsby.
Well, that's Drew Locke and young Neil Young, who have put in an excellent first half. Well, that's what happens at Wembley. 1 minute coasting, and the next, Grimsby are back in. It was a superbly worked goal down the right-hand side again. Good play. And this is a lovely cross to the far post. Black steals in, off the keeper. In fact, it wasn't Neil Young. The keeper got a leg to it, Glass. Couldn't keep it out. Smashing ball by O'Brien, right to the far post. Black stole a march on the defender. And Glass's dreams are shattered. Good header down by Black. Glass, in despair, can't keep it out.
Scored one, but can he turn provider now with the corner? It's away from Handyside, cleared only as far as Donovan. He's looking to Black again. What a potent weapon Black is. He gets this one across again. Burnett strikes it! What a goal! Oh, it's wide! Well, everyone on this side thought that was in. I think Alan Buckley did too. They were out of their seats. It ruffled the net, but it was the wrong side of it.
Yeah, Burnett's reaction tells you it's a great strike. A better second ball this time from Black. Cox heads out. A sweet strike with the left foot. Look at Glass flying. Hits the back of the stanchion. Turi thought that was in. Oh, unlucky. Sit down, Alan.
McDermott. Lee Nogan, who pulled up with cramp a moment ago and was helped by Jamie Vincent. McDermott. Is there a wave through for him? He's gone for it! And what a save! Glass claws it away, and for the second time he's forced to make a magnificent save from McDermott.
I think this is a better save, Rob. McDermott obviously possesses a lethal strike. Smashing. Just makes a little bit of room for himself. Just gets wide on the right foot, blasts it. Great one-handed stop from Glass.
Make no mistake, that would have been the killer blow, and Grimsby still have a corner here. Donovan floats it in, Livingston pressures the goalkeeper. Is it going to take something spectacular to settle this game one way or the other? 15 minutes left now for a golden goal decider in the 1998 Auto Windscreen Shields final. Well, the atmosphere inside Wembley lifting again as Bournemouth urge one final push for the goal that will clinch this final. It's a free kick here to Bournemouth now. Just how much are they going to gamble? They're leaving Young back.
Cox could be the target here. Leaps very well, the captain.
Vincent and Bailey, the two men over it. It's taken by Vincent. It's an awkward one! And Cox stuck his boot out, hopefully.
There, let's have a look. It could have come off ahead, it could have been Burnett, or was it Cox, but good stop. Right down low, and gets a punch away.
A real testing moment that, for the Grimsby goalkeeper, and Davison managing to force it away. McDermott, Smith. Shoveling's layoff. Rogue's trying to force it through, and that was a back pass from Cox. The goalkeeper spilt it anyway. Livingston feeds it across. Howe gets it away, but what were Bournemouth thinking of there?
Well, Cox was too close to Jimmy Glass, and Glass picks this up and drops it, I think. He's maybe forcing it away with this, but there's not a lot of distance between them. The ball eventually comes to Cox. Watch this. He picks it up and then thinks, oh! And eventually the youngster comes to the rescue. A real aberration in the Bournemouth defence. It's cost them a corner. Will it cost them a goal? And it's gone right across it. Burnett is there. A golden goal for Wayne Burnett. He's been struggling all week with flu. That's the best tonic he could have hoped for, because Grimsby's first visit to Wembley has ended with a golden goal that is genuinely 22 carat.
A delight for Grimsby. And as you say, Rob, having the flu, shrugged it off, almost scored earlier with a blockbuster of a left foot. And now, all of a sudden, the smile's back in his face. Just not almost a reaction. Stuck out his left foot, past the helpless Jimmy Glass. Very cruel on Bournemouth. With a left foot, probably the side of his foot. It's a good quality finish, great reaction, and Glass really no chance at all. Superb reaction from Wayne Burnett, and this man's delighted. Get in there, and there's no way back for Bournemouth now.
What a moment for Alan Buckley. He brought in Wayne Burnett from Huddersfield, and it's Burnett who's forgotten all about those flu symptoms now, who's got the goal that has settled the 1998 Auto Windscreen Shield final. Tears all around for Bournemouth, who can't believe the manner in which they've thrown this match away, having initially taken the lead in the first half. But from the seaside town of Cleethorpes, it's the Grimsby supporters who are waving their black and white scarves with pride. Most of their notable successes covered in the black and white era. Twice they reached the FA Cup semi-finals before the war in 1936 and 1939. That was the closest they'd ever come to reaching Wembley before. But Wayne Burnett ensures that it smiles now all around Lincolnshire, because Grimsby have become the 14th different winners of this trophy.
Look at the rain coming down. They don't feel it now. And what a nice tonic. I'm sure when they've celebrated tonight, they thought about it. What an incentive to come back here in a playoff final.
They'll have only the briefest time to celebrate that golden goal winner from Wayne Burnett before the serious business of ensuring their place in the promotion playoffs resumes. But celebrate it, you can be sure they will. But for poor Mel Machin, who saw his team take the lead in the first half with that goal from John Bailey, he now has to go away and pick his players up again. The fans sportingly give a round of applause to Grimsby. Their playoff hopes may well have died, but they'll hope to be back next year challenging for promotion.
Someone buy him a Mars bar, poor kid. Very, very sad, but nothing to be sad about, I don't think. It's a cruel way to end the game. Better than penalties, I must say. But Cox, as he leads his side up, what a good future he's got. I was impressed with many of the Bournemouth players today, Rob. Ian Cox, I reckon there'll be one or two clubs maybe looking at him. Of course, he's disappointed, dejected.
Well, the runners-up medals being presented by Laurie McMenemy, and just on the right of him on your picture is Trevor Watkins, the Bournemouth chairman, who can be delighted with his side's contribution to this match. Indeed, for much of extra time, they look like the stronger side. But that final mix-up at the end, when Glass spilled the back pass from Cox and it led to the corner, has proved so, so costly. It really is the one blot on what has otherwise been an impeccable display from Ian Cox, who can still feel proud after leading his side up the famed Wembley steps.
That's incredible. Away to our right, the Bournemouth fans silent. Just thinking about what may have been when Steen was through near the end. I reckon they've enjoyed their day out though. Little yawn there, tiredness. Whereas up the other end, joyous occasion as Grimsby now go up to get the trophy.
Well, this is a walk that Paul Groves, their captain, has made before with Blackpool when they won the playoff final on penalties. I'm sure he'll be as relieved as anyone that this one didn't go to penalties, but the golden goal was the decider. And the trophy that he's going up for is an impressive monument, the Auto Windscreen Shield. Grimsby adding their name to a list that includes 13 other clubs, including Bournemouth,
first winners in the competition. Groves, in his second spell with the club, deservedly taking the acclaim, posing for pictures, taking the scarf as he proudly bears his colours. And congratulations from a former Grimsby manager in Warren Benemy, who presents the trophy. This is Grimsby's year. And all along the line it will go. Rose being reminded that there's a medal to go with the trophy too. Proud moment for the veterans, the people like John McDermott and Mark Lever, who've given such lengthy service to the club. David Smith, who had to perform roles on the left side of midfield and then at left back when Kingsley Black came on. But the man who stole the glory and is getting a special word of congratulation from Laurie McBenamy is this man, Wayne Burnett. He can throw away those antibiotics now. He's just had the best flu cure ever. Darrell Clare, the young player who was substituted, a disappointment for him, but it all ends in smiles. What a great day this is.
There's a Haddock again, Rob, look. The Haddocks had a good day out. Nice to see little kids, look, on their daddy's shoulders.
Well, they've trawled in the biggest fish of them all on this Wembley afternoon. And he's still coughing a little bit, is Wayne Burnett. But he's the man who trawled it in for them. And the family final has brought smiles to many young faces.
Right, the congested A1 after the game will mean nothing to these people now. It's a lovely day out they've had. It was so finely balanced, wasn't it?
And many generations of Grimsby supporters never saw this, perhaps never thought they'd saw their team at Wembley. But here they are today, and they are winners. And as the song says, they are the champions.
Wonder if they're going to be back, Rob. Playoff final. It's a lovely feeling winning at Wembley. But if they were to come back next month, it'd mean a lot more.
Yes, you might say they've got bigger haddocks to fry with the playoff still to come. Still a lot of work to be done to reach that stage. But they've certainly put down a marker here, and this experience will stand them in very good stead if they are to make a return to Wembley Stadium.
Oh, without a doubt, Rob, you know, some of the youngsters on the side, if they were to come back, they've experienced it, they've sampled it. It's not so nerving.
And these are the photos that they had hoped to be posing for, and Wayne Burnett has more reason than most to feel delighted. Left Huddersfield's battle against relegation earlier in the season when he was discarded by the new manager Peter Jackson. Went initially to Grimsby on loan and has now capped his first season with the club by getting the goal that makes them winners on their first visit here. Proudly standing by the trophy that his goal has secured and getting the congratulations of his captain Groves. That's what it's all been about. And there can be no argument about that on this particular afternoon. Really was a dramatic gamble by Alan Buckley when he sent on Black and Steve Livingston, but it was a substitution that turned the game. Black popping up with a goal, and then Wayne Burnett at the far post from that corner to steer it into the net to get the crunch goal of this fixture.
And they'll remember this day for a long time. First trip to Wembley for most of them, I reckon, watching Grimsby.
They'll stay in the memory for a long time.
Tell you what, they've sold a few fish, haven't they?
Well, they're keen to acknowledge the support they've had and hope that as a result of this, perhaps, future gates of Blundell Park will be swelled. I'm sure they will have enjoyed their day out here because of the spectacle of the game itself. It really was balanced on a knife edge, and it was quite tense for them in that second period of extra time until Burnett cropped up with the winning goal. Bournemouth made a decent fight of it.
Tell you what, you'll be getting a bit of what wind Burnett's got, eh?
Well, in 120 years of history, Grimsby Town Football Club hasn't known anything like this sort of success. And it's no surprise that they are milking into the full. They've given Alan Buckley the perfect birthday present on the eve of his 47th birthday. The man for whom this was a first Wembley final as a manager has led his team to success. Bearing in mind the arduous fixture list that they've had, it is a remarkable tribute to them that they lasted the pace of extra time and still found that little bit of extra in the tank to get the winning goal. A hugely significant day in the history of Grimsby Town. A day that will be etched on the memories of all those who've attended. All the loyal fans who follow them down the years, all the new fans that they've picked up in this magnificent run. And you'll do anything, won't you, when your team have won? Looked better with it, actually, didn't they? A real enthusiast. Finds his emotions very difficult to conceal, does Alan Buckley. It could be quite some birthday celebration for the manager now, thanks to that Burnett goal. Black, Burnett, Buckley, Wembley winners here for Grimsby today. The auto windscreen shield final has finished. Grimsby 2, Bournemouth 1.